So obviously, these past days I've been risking a little bit, putting this movie like here, right? So because I'm scoring this movie at the moment, so I'm gonna keep it there. And now this is the last queue. It's the biggest queue, not the longest queue, but it's gonna be the biggest queue. It's a chase scene, and yeah, here we go. I'll get rid of all this. I don't need all this. So, all right, starts here. So, stairs basically. Gonna make this a little bit bigger so you can see. A little bit. Just a little bit. Background. Blurry. Oh, no, 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 no. All right, so we have this big finale here. Let's see.
Oh my God. Are you okay, baby?
Dad, open. Open your eyes, baby. Are you okay?
Oh my God, baby. Why did you do this?
Wake up.
Yeah. Boom. Alright, so. Oops. Oops. Alright, let's go here. So markers here. So gonna make this a little bit bigger. So she comes out. Boom. Boom. So this we could use. So it's inside, outside, boom, and she starts running. Boom. All right, so marker here. Out. I'm gonna do this as quick as possible because this what? How long is this scene? This is it's a chase. It's not the longest chase, but from hour to 1:20, 1:50. Boom. 1:22. Okay, so 1 minute. 1 minute of music, kind of like chase, action, high intensity, kind of like stinger swell at the end, boom, end. Cops. So 1 hour of 1 hour of like action, 1 minute of tension, and then like the final stingers, and we are out. So let's do this. Let's do markers real quick. I'm gonna put a lot of markers. Hey, Seven Tears of Hope. How are you? Good to see you. All right. So I'm gonna put a lot of markers. So it's gonna be her, him out. So he looks in the opposite direction. He's like, oh, no. But then boom, and then boom, he starts running. And here's where we want to sing. Boom. Boom, right there. Right there. Okay, so marker. So he runs. So the name, I don't care. Just so he runs. And then I decided that we're gonna hit a lot of things here. So boom. So I'm gonna put a lot of markers, as I said. Let's see how close this marker is. But not every, let's see. Let's see. Let's look at the scene. He runs. All right. Cool. So we've got corridor and now stairs. Boom. Boom. So let's see. Let's see. So if we have something like, so when deciding when I'm going to hit, sometimes I'll try things to understand. So yeah, I think it works better than. Let me think. So basically, I'm deciding if I should hit when she opens the door or when or when she starts going down. So for example, if I do this, you're hitting when she starts going down. But if we do this, then we hit when she opens the door. Let's see. I decided that I'm gonna hit a lot of things. That's why I'm putting so many markers. No. All right, let's one more time. Markers are here. Out. Boom.
Get over here.
We're gonna hit the door. Door opening. Boom. J. Door opening. Boom. So door. Door. And then the first time that we... So door, and then there's the stairs. We're going down. We're gonna make a change. It's the same thing, down for a long time. There's a lot of stairs. Yes, boom, and then she gets out. Boom, all right, cool. And boom, door. I'm gonna call this door again. Door. Him. And then, boom, locked. Boom, this. She does great. Boom. Okay, locked. And then he's there, and boom. Boom, hammer. So he hammer. He hits her with the hammer. Boom. She's in the ground, and then he grabs her, and then here. I'm gonna call this neck, and then boom. Yeah. Hammer going up, and boom. Savior appears. And tsh. Tsh. Boom. All right, hit. That's her mom. Hits the bad guy. And when we think we are done, she's gonna do it one more time. So, stinger start. So, when do we end here? No, let's see, let me try. It's gonna be another. Now, here, okay, cool, I understand. It's gonna be very simple. And the when we hear the hit, boom, right there is the end of a stinger. And the stinger. All right, I think we're done. Boom. So. Oh, well, actually, you know, it'd be nice if it ended a little bit earlier.
Dispatch, this is 12 Adam 88 requesting clearance to sign at 1800 hour.
What's your location? 12 Adam 88.
Oh, we're at Pico and Figueroa. Copy that, dispatch 12 Adam 88 out.
Yeah, yeah. No, with that we are good, I think. The next one is a different queue. So short. All right, cool. I just did a big queue earlier. I composed 16 minutes of music this weekend. I feel a little bit drained. But the last queue was going from minute 15, minute 21. That was the longest queue. And I did that in the afternoon. Yeah, a lot of music this weekend. I had to do it. All right, cool. Let's take a look at this one more time. So we've got door. Boom. Then we've got... Boom, he starts running. And then turn. I don't think we need to make any change there. You can stay. We can have the same music here. Boom, change. Okay, we've got stairs. 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 A lot of stairs. Oh, there you go. I like that. I like that. Okay, so one problem that I was seeing in this chase was that I wasn't seeing him. I wasn't seeing them close together. You can see one of them, the other one of them, but not close. And that's cool here. So here's where you see that he's about to catch her. There you go. So maybe we can do... So he's not that far. So, boom. I'm gonna call this he's close. He's close. He's close! Alright, cool. And then we've got one bar actually. Boom. So we can do stinger G. Boom. Then, you know, second part, he's close. And then we've got, so we're changing here. We're going from kind of like stairs corridor to this open area here. Boom, right? So that gives us an opportunity to change. Let's see. Now he should be, and then we hide this door so we don't know where he is. But we know he's close, and then she can't open because it's locked. So we are screwed. Right, boom. And so what are we gonna do here? Don't worry, folks, I'll start composing in a sec. So it's locked, but let's see. Let's see, I don't know what I'm going to do, but I'm just gonna have the marker here. I'm gonna say this open area. This is not an example of how you set markers, just the markers that I set for this particular scene. And I don't know what I'm going to hit. That doesn't mean that I'm going to hit everything. Now, we've got a lot of stairs. Let's see. I feel more comfortable. Do we have halfway something that would be meaningful? Let's see. So we've got, let's see. It's close. Alright, so I think we can hear. Let me see, one more time. I think. Maybe so when he enters, so we can see her going down, and then boom, we can see him. Door, we're gonna call this door him. Door him. Then we've got a little more of the structure here. Yeah, so he hits the ground, we're gonna, boom, here you go, music. I'm gonna call this hit, just, and we've got a little bit more of a structure here. We can do some musical changes that are meaningful. All right, cool. All right, let's do some music. Let's do some music. All right. let's get started. It should be fun. I don't know what I'm going to do, but I've been composing for, and I've done 30 minutes of music for the past week, so got my motifs and my themes and my sounds. So now this is going to be the biggest cue. It's a different style than that most of what I've done in the movie. Most of what I've done is kind of like, you know, horror thriller type of thing. So this is more intense, meaning the template is, I have to open the template and enable some of the tracks that I haven't used in the entire movie. That's okay, because this is the climatic scene, so it's meant to be bigger. Here we go. Now, when is the music going to... So, let's see. So this is the last cue. No. So this, I think this is a tempo. The tempo is going to be something like. Like 210? 210. All right, let's do that. So we're gonna go here. Here is where we're gonna switch to 210. Let's see, because I think this is going to be more like 7/8. Yeah, but not at the beginning. Yeah, so let's see 210. What do we have? 210. No, we're gonna go E. So. Yeah. Ah, cool. Feels good. Yeah, I think this is the kind of the right. 210, cool. So. There you go. But let's adjust those hits, because now they have to be very tight. So 210 will do it, but I think for this first one we're gonna have to go a little bit higher. So we're gonna bring up the tempo here. No, so lower. Boom. And then it's gonna be 1, 2, 3. And here we can change the, maybe we'll see. But maybe here I envision the having the 7/8 here. Yes, cool. Now we're gonna have a tempo change here. It is going to be something like this. Gonna go a little bit faster. 215. Just so we get the tempo kind of like, or the feel of this is going to be. Let me see. We're gonna activate this guy here. So it's gonna sound like this. No, I thought this would happen. Ah, save. I thought this would happen. I thought of saving before this. Nah. Dang. Crap. Ning. Sorry. I thought I'm gonna save because I haven't tested this track in this new template. Ah! And I didn't wanna save. And this has happened. Dang. Alright, let's see. Let's see if I have what did they lose? Okay, so it's 4:50. What time is it? It's 6 at the moment. The last save, it's 6:03. Okay, so I've got, okay, so great. I've got something saved 4 minutes ago. All right, so let's kill this. And task. Oh. Wait a minute, save. Really? All right, so it did not crash, but I crashed it. So fun. So much fun. All right. I mean, E. I think I'm going to go in key. It's going to be E. Sorry. All right. Okay. Can we do this? I've got 90 minutes to write this key. I think it's a 1 minute queue, so it should be doable. Just back in case. This is the guy. A backup. Yes, I want the backup. Sorry, I should have forgot. The backup, blah, 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 blah. Yes. Yeah, they're going down the stairs. And I've got a motif that I'll show you later. That's kind of, it's going down. Hey, Combo Bear, Cruz! ¿Qué tal? Have to tell Esteban that I am not available. Hey, come on! Alright, you're gonna open. Go, come on, load. All right, this is the end of the movie, so I've got a lot of tracks active. There you go, let's go. All right, let's see, one more time. Hey, I've got the markers. Okay, I was worried because I don't like, all right, cool, we've got all the markers. We've got a tempo change. That's good. All right. So we're going to file save us. And this is going to be what? Chasing, right? Yeah. So 53. So it's going to be M53. Yeah. So, So M53, I call this chase CPR. That's it. Copy. It's gonna go in a new folder, paste, boom, boom. Save. There we go. Now. Alright. Ready? See if we can start composing. I'm gonna open this, gonna make it a little bit bigger so we can see our template. And now we're gonna activate this guy. Please don't crash, please. There you go. So we do not have, okay, so we, okay. So tempo, and this is gonna be a little bit slower, so it's boom. So it's perfect. All right. Then we've got this, taka 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 taka, boom. And then we've got this happening here. When she comes out, we're gonna switch to 7/8, 7/8, boom. And then we've got this one that has to sing here. So we're gonna go here, T for tempo, we're gonna go up, boom. There you go. Then he runs, and then so, oops, no, sorry, wrong. There you go. Let's see. This one has to be... okay. There. Now, here we're going to make the change as well as tempo change. Boom. Tempo change. Now, here we're going to go to... What? This? No. Has to be a little bit faster. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's not that big of a change because we are changing timing signature as well. So, and then we've got this guy here. So, tempo change here. Oops. Tempo change here. Great. And what? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. Let's see. If I... There you go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Make it all 1, 2, 3, 4. Show. So this is gonna be a 2/4. This could be a 2/4, but let's discuss this later. This could be a 2/4, and then boom, and then 7/8 again. But let's discuss this later because I don't know exactly. This one's perfect, or is it? Yeah, we can do the same thing. We could do the same thing. Let's see. 2/4, and then 7/8. 7/8. Look at that. How they match perfectly. You could do 2/4. We'll see this. We'll see about this in the 7/8. All right, cool. And then, all right, let's get back to this in a second later on. Let's just talk about some music, and then we'll decide the other things. So, okay, so Command S. Hey, Daniel, thanks for the kind words. All right, we're ready. So, okay, as we were saying, this is the end of the other cue. Oh. All right. Got it. And boom, she's out. Maybe, you know what, we'll keep it simple. Oops. We're gonna start with this. Well, she's out. Boom. It went. Maybe we didn't have to perfectly finish this glissando, because we're gonna hit this. Or let's see. This is hard. That's why I'll write this dun 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 dun, dun. Because this will help me.
Get off!
Michael. All right. We're good to go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's do this. So, dun 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 dun. So we're gonna. This is gonna be 8, and so it's gonna be easier to quantize. Boom, boom. Everything. Yes. Yeah. Then I think I need 2 bars here. Gonna make this a little bit bigger. When do we have the tempo change? The time signature change here. There you go. Copy paste. Up. Great. So when she's out, now we've got kind of like, I don't need the kick anymore. What happens? Dun dun. Dun dun. Dun dun out. Bien. Dun dun out. Great. And then I can cut a little bit more of this guy. This guy here. Exactly. No, I needed 1 more bar. No. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Boom. Oops. Boom. Hello. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There you go. There you go. And so. Great. Boom. And then him. And got this 2-2. This will make sense as we start composing. And then the 2-2. Where's the 2-2? Here. 2-2 again. And then again. And then we'll continue. We'll see from. We'll take it from there. All right. But so far, I think we've got. All right. Let's see. Let's compose some music. So basically, chase the scene. So. So E, right? So we are in E. And here you go. And what? Cool. Start there. And let's hit this with this guy here. Long, short. Where's it? Yeah, let's keep that tail. Great, awesome. So, right, so it's going to be what? Short. So it's we are in E. So we'll see. So we've got this. Mm-hmm. So we've got the motif is. So here's what we're going. We'll save this for later because this works. So here. So we're gonna write the key switches here. Couldn't keep up. Ding ding gedi gong gong garaga gang gang gedi gong gong gara. So this works. Ding 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 Press, but let's just a little bit here. So we're gonna perfect this. Then we're gonna repeat. Din, 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 dun dun da 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 dun dun da 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 dun dun da 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 dun dun da da da. Dun dun da 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 dun dun da 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 din din da 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 dun dun da da da. Yeah. Dun dun da 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 dun dun da 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 din din da 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 dun dun da da da. So it's gonna be in the A sharp. There you go. Let's see. And yeah, that's for the next section. I feel that I need to change this. Let's wait. Wait for it, Mark. This guy is gonna go here. Yes. And then that just 1, 2, 3, 5, three more bars, and you're free to go. 1, 2, 3. With something else. So we've got. Maybe we can repeat the. So. Din din di bi dum bum ba da ba dum bum ba da ba boom boom. What J? So boom boom boom. There you go. Din din di di dun dun da 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 dun dun. Din din. So we've got 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Din din di di dun. 1, 2, 3 and a 2, 2. 1, 2, 3 and a 2, 2. Let's make this bigger. Din din di di dun dun da 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 dun dun. Din din di di dun dun da da dun. Din din di di dun dun da 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 dun dun. Din din di di dun dun da 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 dun dun. Din din di di dun dun da da dun. Dun dun da da dun. Bam boom. Shut down. And then here we're gonna. I don't know what it's going to be, but it's going to be something like. That was good. Sorry. No, can't do better. No, choir. Full orchestra. Alright, cool. So the GT structure will add the energy in a second. Alright, so Cubase 12 worth upgrade, by the way. Nah, I like the color of it. It's blue now. That's the same thing for what I use. And Cubase 11, I haven't even looked into it at all. No worries. Took about a year break from music, just coming back to it fresh. This is not the best class to get to. Also, Mark, ever consider using Babylon Waves articulation mapping? Oh, yeah, no. Would definitely get your track count down. No. I know all my key switches, don't need to. Yeah, my system is very simple. I try to keep it very simple, and I'm trying to simplify it even more. No more, you know. What the fuck? Sorry. Why do I have the... Let's have some fun. Let's orchestrate this. Alright, so we're gonna do this. What was the note? Let's syncopate this a little bit more. Yes. Let's not syncopate it, because I think it. No. Let's do syncopate it. We're not trying for this to be. I'll let you see what's going on in the screen there. Very small, but. Not feel very inspired, but let's keep going. Let's keep going. There you go. Yeah. So here we go, and... and then down. This can bring this down a tad. Then and then. And so boom out. We don't need the second hit. Second brass thing. Oops. So this violence one. Alright. Short notes. Oh. gonna introduce the motive that's coming on later on. I was doing good, but then I messed up. So this was, we're here in D, so now. I was doing good. How many more? How many more? Ah, here. Where's the two? Here. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, perfect. Come on. Will I be able to do this? Then F sharp. Dun, dun, da, 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 dun, dun. Yes. Bam, bam. All right, let's quantize this. Bring it to the right place. Don't quantize this too perfectly, because they wouldn't be able to play this perfectly. Now let's do a little bit of, compressing the notes, and then bring it up just this side so it goes up, and then like this. Now it's an action cue, we're gonna need a lot of space. So we're gonna create a little bit of a space for violins. One, we're gonna move it to the to the left. Ooh, see that? Boom, boom. Dun, dun. We're gonna need that orchestral hits a little bit soft, so we're gonna need to write a little bit of. They're at the 2-2. Yes, boom, boom. I don't think I'll have time to use this cue as I want. I got a boom, bam. Here we're gonna have this Titan symbol. And the timpani, of course. Dun dun did a boom bam. Where's my timpani? Timpani, oh, it's so slow today. Sorry. Dun dum, dun dim. Trying to find the right balance. Dun dun da da boom bam. Yes, center, right? Yes, center ba. Then we can hear. A little bit to the right. So we're gonna move a little bit this guy to the left. Just a tad. There you go, just a tad. Just a tad. There you go. Let's continue. Diggity bam bam. Is it working? Dan dan wa. So dan dan ju. So to the next, it has to be bigger. Dan dan. So we're gonna need a rip or something. A woodwind rip. Where do I have them? Haven't used them in this template. So I'm gonna save. Comments. And then angel choirs. Exactly, Facundo. Yeah. Oh, good, just wondering. All right. So the new template without BE Pro is still working out okay. Yes. Where am I going? Yes. yeah, so far, so good. I've done an entire movie. It works. I like it. The CPU load less. The saving time a little bit too big. But so far, so good. I like it because I save a queue and it's self-contained. I don't have to deal with having something else saved. Anyway, let's continue. So this thing has actually to be a preparation for the next hit. Dun dun, or dun dun. No, because we're gonna change. Dun. No. We have to change direction. We have to do something like da 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 da. So, dore dore dire dore dore dare dore dore dare dire. Let's go. You know what? What I like to do in this case is just go later. Yeah. Dore dore dare 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 dare. Dore dore dire dare 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 dare. Oops, oops. Dore dore dire dare 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 dare. Dore dore dire dare 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 dare. A little bit more. Dore dore dire dare 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 dare. Dore dore. What? No, this has to be louder. Dore dore dore. Dore dore, important, very important. Dore dore dire dore dore. 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 Dore da da da. Strong. Dire da. So. Dore dore dire dore dore dire da. Dire da. Dore dore dire dore. Dore dire da. Yeah, let's go. Dore dore dire do, dire do, dire do da 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 da, dire do. Dore dore dire do, dore dore da da da, dore dore dire do, dore dore da da da. Yeah, dore dore da da da, dore dore dire do, dore dore da da, dore dore dire do. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. Great. Okay, now this guy is going to go. Boom, bam, jada, dada. What I did wrong? No. There you go, this guy. Boom, bam, dim. Dun, dan, gra. So, dun, dan. So, two, I've got, dun, dan. Again, same thing. Close this guy. Dun, dan, ras. And it's gonna be something like this. Dun, dan, dun. A little bit more like this. That is not a very. Let's go to the. Let's go to G. Yeah. All right. So, what do we have so far? This is not orchestrated, by the way. course. Ding ding da ba bim bim better bim bim better. Let's repeat this. Ding ding da ba bim bim better ba bim bim better. Yes, in large part. No worries. Ding ding da ba bim bim. How boring can this be? Nah, we'll make it interesting. With something like. Later on. Oh, by the way, we had the marker here, right? Yes, 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 we did. Yes. Din din boom, din din bam, din din da da da. Din 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 din. Na dun dun na. Maybe in this case. So where's my tempo? Alright, cool. So we're gonna change the articulation key. Now, cool. Too loud, I know. Jambam. I know that I'm using the violins and I'm stacking them. That's a, you know, no problem for this cue. That's okay. Just want to move fast because, man, I won't have time to finish this at all. But for now, we've got the structure at least. That's good. All right, so this was before. Cool. Yes. Here. And this is after. It's gonna go down because this articulation has more power. Now, where's the articulation? Hello? And not the articulation. No, this was supposed to be expression, whatever. So this expression, and now there you go. Cool. So this is gonna go here. And this was modulation. Modulation, and now we can. And now we need this guy. There you go. Till the end. But again, we'll do this later. Let's work till here. Let's see what we can do. Yes. So two more. Cool. Missing one note, but that's okay. Did my note come back? Yes, there you go. This should start earlier, right? I think so. Most definitely. J. safe. Unknown says that sounds generic to the structure. Now, you know what? I think we shouldn't change here. Yeah, that's where we'll change. All right, let's start orchestrating this part. Bam, bam. Let's see. Dun dun diggity dun dun diggity dun dun. Get it, boom, bam. Gonna go down a little bit, too loud. Ding, 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 ding. Violas on an octave. Gonna open them a little bit. No, just starting here. There you go. Not to the entire time. Make sure that we have all the right key switches. What is going on with the choir? Here we go, let me see. Oops. switch it up. See. Let's open the template. I'm gonna need these guys, maybe. Hi. Yes. Do you have E? No. Much better. No. I have to rewrite this. Ding dang da da dun dun da 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 da. Jay. Cut. 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 Yeah, yeah, exactly. That's what I was. What about Facundo and I are connected? I was gonna do this guy here. Eternal ribs. Thank you. Drone sample mute. A little bit more of these guys. -2. Oops. Bum bum baraka dun 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 dun. Hence that with two horns short. Zanana. Zagadam. Yeah, exactly. Da-da-da. This design being the loudest. And these are too loud. Too loud. Gonna minus what? Minus 4. And now everything needs to be a little bit louder. Which makes sense. Yes. Shagagua. So as he starts running. We've got this, but we could do something like this. Start a little bit earlier. Yes. And then here we have to cut. Boom. Down. Oof, not that short. Ah, great, yes. Don't like this. Ah, bit by bit, bit by bit. This takes forever. Let's see what we've got available here. This is so. I mean, boom, ding, dee, do, de, dum. Can we? So, 1 second. So, one. No, not that opened. Great, awesome. Great, okay, now we have to make it a little louder. Yeah, great. J. Me. Boom. Boom. Double bases. Ding dong dun dun. They're gonna copy and paste this shoe. Where is it? Bassoons and control zones. Come on. Paste. Paste. Snare. Where's my snare? And then we can get rid of the other snare that I hit here, because maybe we can do something like this. Yes, da-di-dim, da-di-dim, da-di-dim with trombones, da-di-dim. Ensemble, trombone, ensemble, turn, da-di-dim. Short and long. Okay, so got a little bit. So because this template is a little bit easier to use than the other one, I'm just gonna duplicate and there you go. Now I'm gonna have the short here and the long down here. So this long and this, gonna get rid of this guy. Now the short has to go to brass short and the long has to go to brass long. There you go. No problem. So this and this. Now this is long, so it should go down here. This is the long note. So key switch. No. Key switch this guy. There you go on the short key switch. This is confusing. Get rid of it. Dirty dim. Can we? Dirty dim. Where did I play this exactly? Dirty dim. Dirty dim. That's it, team. There's something that is not perfectly. Where's my? There. Not the thing. One, two. Three. Let's see. Okay, let's do a little bit of negative delay here. Like minus 10. What's going on with the snare? The snare, it's clearly dirty. This is cool. Minus 3. Let's see. Yeah, it's maybe if we move it here. Let's do the beginning of the. So 1, 2, 3. Let's do it at the beginning of the bar. Pa-pa-pam. Pa-pa-pam. Bones a little bit late, and this is what takes time. What is this? Oh yeah, the bassoons. No. There you go. Alright, let's do just got the cellos and what I wanted. Maybe they're not that bad, right? Yes, exactly. Perfect. Yeah. Dirty boo. Dirty boo. Yes. Dirty boo. Downer. Dirty boo. Downer, perfect, perfect. Then let's start here. Sub bum. Let's save it. Let's drink some water. Yes. Same thing with double basses. So we're gonna copy. Hello. Merge. Bring it down here. Perfect. Let's make it not as obvious. Bada bum. So we're gonna need da-da-da-ra. Yeah. So bada. There you go, exactly that. So beam bump. Super syncopated here. And then we're gonna do swell here. Right. Or maybe what do we have here? Why is this so much louder? Maybe this guy? Not as much. So then we're gonna need dan crack crack crack. Where's the all right, cool. How are we going to tunkra? A little bit here. That's perfect. Think of, not as loud. Not as loud the timpani either. So these wah. You need a little bit of speed on the right side, so yes. So I like this, yeah. Have to die these guys. Mistake. Okay, we're orchestrating percussion now. Let's see. Super dry. Money, gotta get gang. Ah, let's do. Let's bring the big guys. Like this one. The whole piece is in 7/8. No, not all the piece. Just 99% of it. I think we're done. Yeah, I have to stop here because I have to take my kids to school later. Let's compress velocities. There you go. Maybe a little bit of Titan. Tantum. Yeah. Then here we can entice. I like it a little better not quantized, actually. So alright, great. I'm gonna move the lead. But I'm not gonna quantize. Like, I'm gonna rush this. So, let's go one more time. Thank you. There you go. Bam. Where's me? Me. Yes, I think we're good. Yes, I think we're good. Just that. I think we have composed out of how much? So 12 seconds of music. Yeah, that's how it is. Oh man, my gosh. It's fun. I'm having a lot of fun. It's gonna be a fun day. I don't like the tin tan better though. Maybe we can keep this small, doke, for contrast. Yes, doke, boom, and then come back. And then he's back. Yes, it would make sense, right? Now, I don't think we need this. Yeah. And this is... No. This is gonna go to woods as well. Woods. I have to go now. And command S. There you go. Copy it here, and then I'm gone. Yeah, my boy. No examples. It's too thick, I know. Load. Yeah. Reload all samples. So I don't have to wait. It's the highest it goes. Another patch. Thought I could go with. Maybe we'll try this guy copy. Now, can I get rid of this guy? Let's see. Or maybe not. Yes, I like it. Yeah, it works. Okay. Let's go here. Let me record. up here, and this has to sound a little bit more to the left. Oops, not here. Yeah. It's too loud. It's too loud. So I'm gonna bring it down. And then, yeah, see my boy. Minus 9. And then we're gonna bring it down. Yeah. Gonna do is we're gonna have this guy, and then we're gonna have 2D octaves short. We're gonna activate this as well. We're gonna bring this here. We're orchestrating. J, yes, copy, paste. Now this is gonna go down an octave, I guess. Let's listen to the whole thing. This is what, too loud again. Gonna bring, oh yes, minus 2, let's see, because this guy is 4-9. Okay, let's take a listen to these two. No, just this. Two of them. Now bring this down a little bit, but also here it's gonna be minus, this is 4, this is okay, minus 3. And now all, and it's too loud. Minus 6. Nine. Let's see. Let's open this. What's going on? This works. This works great. But it's just a little bit too loud. Perfect. Okay. We'll come back here. To the wood blocks. Wood blocks. Yes. Let's go. As I'm back, okay? All right, everyone. Thanks so much for joining. The whole thing. I'll see you later. See you in the next one. Bye-bye. Hello. Hey, everyone. How are you guys doing?
Hey.
Good to see ya. Good to see. Hey, Pozzolo, how are you? Good to see you.
Hey, good.
How are you? Hey, Victoria. Good. Thank you. Thanks for asking. Very excited. Sorry for starting a few minutes late. We had a small little confusion. We thought that we would be starting a little bit later. But we're all good. Very excited to have you here. Appreciate that you are here. Let's get started. This should be a lot of fun. I was working on a movie. I just finished. We just delivered the cue sheet. So we just finished the movie recently. And I wanted to talk about a little bit, like first 20, 30 minutes about film scoring structure. And then maybe this sparks some questions. We can take the second part of the class for Q&A. But let's see where this leads. All right. So first things first, what I would recommend is make sure that you mute your mics. If you want to ask any question, raise your hand here on Zoom, click the button, and then we'll give you, you can unmute your mic and ask the question. But if we mute your mics, that way we avoid, you know, background noise getting through. Okay, so with that being said, let's get this started with, I'm gonna make you a little bit smaller. I'm gonna put you on the side. I'm gonna play a video of the spotting session of this movie. And so I'll give you a little bit of context. What happened in this movie is what happens in every movie. Before we start, there's a spotting session. And some of you that were in the last chat, Victoria, you saw this clip already. But there was a lot of people that was not in that class. So that part I'm going to repeat, because we're going to expand the discussion in structure when it comes to film scoring. So again, we did the spotting session. So I'll play back a moment of the spotting session. By the way, the spotting session is when you have this long meeting with the director and you watch the entire movie with them. And you decide that there's a discussion regarding where the music should be. In, out, the mood, what the music should do, etc. Right? So it's if the movie is 2 hours, generally that meeting is gonna go for a day or a couple of days. The shortest type of meeting that I've done out of this spotting session for a feature film, it's 4 hours generally. And this particular one, this is a director that I've done over 12 movies with, and so there's a component of trust. We've worked together in the past. This was a thriller suspense movie, and I've done many movies with this director and this exact same production company. So we did not complete the entire spotting session. There was the component of trust. So in this case, we just spent 90 minutes together. And there was one moment where there was a scene and there was no music. In that particular, there was no temp track in that particular scene, and the director told me, "Hey, I think this scene needs music, and it needs to come in right here." It was a kind of like a weird place for the music. It was not a clear cue for the music to come in, but he had a great idea. That's why you have to trust director. Most of the times, they have a much better idea of the story than yourself. And it's like, I think music needs to, we need music in this scene, music needs to come in right here. And that was like, huh, okay. And because I didn't have temp track, I asked him, do you mean something like this musically? And I scored the scene live, which... And it was very successful. Like I scored the scene live and it actually worked. But most of the times it doesn't work. But in that particular case, it worked. And so I just wanted to show you the clip first. And then I wanted to make a quick analysis of why it worked. And I'm going to put the emphasis on structure first. Obviously, there are other more obvious components. So like melodically, why it works, timbrically, why it works in terms of orchestration. And we will discuss those things as well. But hey, Gregory, good to see you. Let's just play back the video, okay? Let me know if the sound comes through, and then let's discuss why it worked. So we're talking about this scene. I'm going to go ahead and see. This is the fleshed out version of the scene. I'm going to go ahead and just mute these guys, and I'm gonna move you guys out of the way just for a second so I can. I'm gonna mute. Oh no, in fact, sorry, video. And this happened in minute. So this is a video, as you can see, this guy is a video. This happened, this is myself and Doug Campbell, as you can see, I tend to use the same jumper. So when it comes to scoring, it seems like. And this happened in minute, give me just 1 second that I remember. Give me just 1 sec. This was in the spotting session minute. Give me just 1 sec. I forgot. Well, I'll just find out. Yes. So this is, there you go, this is the scene. And yes, this is me. We just 1 sec, sorry for. Okay, now because, okay, we just 1 sec.
Why'd you hit him like that?
No, a little bit earlier. There you go.
Sure he is. You don't believe him, do you?
No.
Give me just one sec. I find this exact same moment.
We can also
see you later.
Yeah, yeah. I hope it's not too loud. Let me know if you can hear the body.
What else did he say? That he was in therapy and he's doing a lot better? Sure he is. You don't believe him, do you? No.
We can also have here the... Yeah, let's see.
Sorry for this. It's just 1 second. It's a long video. There you go.
You don't believe him, do you? No.
We can also have here the... Yeah, let's see. Kind of
you don't believe him, do you? No, of course mm-hmm. not.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
I
yeah.
I have to admit, he is, I don't know, convincing. That's because he's a lying manipulator and a wife beater. You know, he's always been this way. Actually, he only freaked out on me that one time. I mean, it was totally out of nowhere. Out of nowhere? He's been that way since the very beginning. I mean, we all saw how messed up he was. We? Who's we? Me. Rochelle, Shamika. I mean, look, we tried to tell you, but you were so in love that you wouldn't listen. I mean, don't you remember how he would just flip out over the smallest thing? That was just him being picky. That was him being a nightmare control freak. Listen, he's working you, and you're starting to believe his lies again. No, I am not. We all do it. We fall in love, we think they're perfect, but because the love makes us stupid, we don't see who they really are. You're lucky. You know why? Why? Because the night he tried to kill you, he showed you his true colors, that's for damn sure. He's gonna contact you again. He's gonna try to convince you that he's not a threat. But no matter what he says, no matter what you feel inside, do not look at me. Do not engage him. That restraining order pertains to you as well. You hear what I'm saying? I hear you. Okay, well, I need to eat and shower and get on the road. I've got meetings back to back for the next 3 weeks. Oh, and we need your pages.
Yeah, that's the...
And then...
Wow, that's great, Mark. You know, it's so great. Just that little touch. It says that she's explaining the...
Cool, awesome. So it kind of like... Let me just give you some context about the story real quick. Let's go back here. And then we'll watch the scene once again, and I'll show you the notes and everything and how I scored this. But making sure that my image is back, okay, and you're here, I'm gonna bring you back here. Okay, cool. Oops, what happened? Okay, there you go. So essentially, let's take a look at the scene just once again. And I believe the reason why this works is because subconsciously, and obviously I watched this movie before the spotting session, right? I have an understanding of the story. Also, I have a motive already. I have sent the director and a sweet, like a 3 minutes piece of music with a, you know, few themes developed. I also have sent the director and a scene, a score. So I already had the kind of the tone, the motives, part of this, you know, pre-score approved before doing the spotting session. So those motives, those kind of, you know, tritone and this type of minor intervals in the melody, this kind of thing, right? It's plus the sound, very traditional strings type of thing. It was approved. He liked this style. That's what I could go. I was not improvising. I was using stuff from the main theme that has already been approved through the suite and like a test scene that I sent to him. Great. Awesome. But I think what makes this thing successful, what I just did there live in front of him, was that I understood the structure of the scene. And I think that's very, very important. Let's take a listen. Now this is Cubase. So let's take a listen to this once again.
Of course not. But I have to admit, he is, I don't know, convincing. That's because he's a lying manipulator and a wife beater. You know, he's always been this way. Actually, he only freaked out on me that one time. I mean, it was totally out of nowhere. Out of nowhere? He's been that way since the very beginning. I mean, we all saw how messed up he was. We? Who's we? Me? Rochelle? Shamika?
As I move forward, try to identify, this is, by the way, has three, this scene, in my opinion, has three parts. And most of everything in life, in scoring, in kind of movie structure, in even song structure, generally, is going to have this three-act structure. So try to find the three parts or the three mini-acts inside of this scene. Let's start from the beginning again. And by the way, and you can see musically, if you look at this MIDI region here, you should see also the three parts, not just melodically, but also structurally. So it's just something for, I'm going to make this a little bit bigger, but you can right there see the structure. But let's take a listen again to this again.
You don't believe him, do you? No, of course not. But I have to admit, he is, I don't know, convincing. That's because he's a lying manipulator and a wife beater. You know, he's always been this way. Actually, he only freaked out on me that one time. I mean, it was totally out of nowhere. Out of nowhere? He's been that way since the very beginning. I mean, we all saw how messed up he was. We? Who's we? Me? Rochelle? Shamika? I mean, look, we tried to tell you, but you were so in love that you wouldn't listen. I mean, don't you remember how he would just flip out over the smallest thing? That was just him being picky. That was him being a nightmare control freak. Listen, he's working you, and you're starting to believe his lies again. No, I am not. We all do it. We fall in love, we think they're perfect, but because the love makes us stupid, we don't see who they really are. You're lucky. You know why? Why? Because the night he tried to kill you? He showed you his true colors, that's for damn sure. He's gonna contact you again. He's gonna try to convince you that he's not a threat. But no matter what he says, no matter what you feel inside, do not look at me. Do not engage him. That restraining order pertains to you as well. You hear what I'm saying? I hear you. Okay, well, I need to eat and shower and get on the road. I've got meetings back to back for the next 3 weeks.
Okay, awesome. In my opinion, after seeing this multiple times, pretty obvious. But anyone in the room would like to take a shot at explaining the three parts of this scene based on what you see? It's not good or wrong. It's not right or wrong. It's just your view on this. Pocholo is like, I'm out of here.
Sorry.
No, it's good. It's great to see you. How are things over there?
Doing good, really.
How's college?
Almost done.
Awesome. Congrats. So, yeah. All right.
Thanks.
I'll go ahead and I'll explain myself, but here's what I see, okay? So, if you see musically, we can also see it's broken up in three parts, right? We've got this part here, we've got this part here, and then we've got this part here, right? Let's again take a listen to the first part of the conversation, how it opens. It opens with...
You don't believe him.
You don't believe him, right? So just obviously it's a little bit harder for you, but I hesitated to kind of like to show the entire movie, but... The movie starts with a murder, right? And it's the police breaking in the house and finding someone that's supposedly dead and a supposed guilty, right? Which is the husband, and then is the dead body coming up here.
52 en route.
Let me see.
Officer 008 requesting a 1052.
Right. And then the husband gets accused as the person who's committed murder. And that's a conversation. And then it develops. And basically the story is in regards of if he is the actual guilty or not. And this is the conversation that they are having. And so this was the person who was supposed to be dead. It was, she was not dead. And she's a writer. This is her friend and agent as well. She believes it was the husband. And now that the husband got out of jail, she's having doubts if she was or not. And this is the conversation that's going on. And so the husband contacted her to try to just convince her that he was not guilty. He didn't, he never did that. And so that's why the conversation starts with, you don't believe him, right?
You don't believe him, do you?
No, of course not. But I have to admit, he is, I don't know, convincing.
That's because he's a lying manipulator and a wife beater. You know, he's always been this way.
Actually, he only freaked out on me that one time. I mean, it was totally out of nowhere.
Out of nowhere? He's been that way since the very beginning.
So first part is basically a question. It's like, you don't believe him, right? It's like, well, and there's a conversation regarding like, well, I'm not going to tell you that I believe him, but I don't know, he's convincing. And what the melody is doing, or what the music is doing, it's kind of like presenting a concept. It's not concluding that concept, right? Right, but it's kind of like the beginning of, it's playing around with this semitone, right? And it's, by the way, it's part of the motif. But
no,
you don't believe him, right?
No, of course not. But I have to admit, he is, I don't know, convincing.
That's because he's a lying manipulator and a wife beater. You know, he's always been this way.
Actually, he only freaked out on me that one time. I mean, it was totally out of nowhere.
Out of nowhere?
Okay, cool. Well, it's kind of like the melody, it's kind of trying to get this started just the way the conversation is trying to get this started, right? Now they are going to go a little bit deeper, and so the melody is going to do the same thing. By the way, this is live scoring. This is by no means perfect or in any way, okay? But still, it's somehow successful, and it's because I think, in my opinion, one of the most important elements of a scoring, which is getting a structure right, it's decent, it's pretty good, it's pretty accurate, it works, right? Then you'll see, finally, I'll show the fleshed out version of this cue, and it sounds better, and it feels more complete, but it's that 20% addition. This is the most important part, okay? So conversation gets started, the first part, and it's basically they are discussing, you don't believe him, right? First part of the scene. The second part of the scene is her, the friend, making her point, right? Now we're going to present a more developed version of the melody, which starts here.
Out of nowhere, he's been that way since the very beginning. I mean, we all saw how messed up he was.
We? Who's we?
Me, Rochelle, Shamika. I mean, look, we tried to tell you, but you were so in love that you wouldn't listen. I mean, don't you remember how he would just flip out over the smallest thing?
That was just him being picky.
That was him being a nightmare control freak. Listen, he's working you, and you're starting to believe his lies again.
No, I am not.
We all do it.
Boom. Okay? So you can see this very slow melody, that it has a beginning and an end, and it follows the second part of this scene. It has three parts. Okay, at the beginning it opens with a question. Now the friend makes her point, and with the point you can kind of like see the arc of this melody and concluding here as she concludes her point, right?
Believe his lies again.
No, I am not.
He's working you, and you're starting to believe his lies again.
No. He's working you, and you start to believe his lies again. By the way, see that the melody plays around the dialogue. Right. So when generally when there's a space in between their discussion, the melody is more active. So that now that's at more at the micro level. That's basically a scoring technique. but the melody does not interfere as much with the dialogue or as much as possible. It tries to minimize the conflicting as much as possible. And where important things are said, there's a space like this one.
Oh, freak. Listen, he's working you. And you're starting to believe his lies again.
No, I am.
Right? So let's see how this happens again.
Beginning. I mean, we all saw how messed up he was.
We? Who's we?
Me, Rochelle, Shamika. I mean, look, we tried to tell you, but you were so in love.
So it's subtle, but, and then there's a little bit of a space, and that's where we do like the music da-da-da-da thing, and then we continue for the log notes to give space for dialogue.
I mean, look, we tried to tell you, but you were so in love that you wouldn't listen. I mean, don't you remember how he would just flip out over the smallest thing?
That was just him being picky.
That was him being a nightmare control freak. Listen, he's working you. And you're starting to believe his lies again.
No, conclusion. I am not.
We all do it.
Conclusion of that second part. So we've got the first part. We are introducing the problem, right? Now the second part, the friend is making her point or explaining what she believes. And then she's going to develop, right? So melodically, we present it with kind of like an opening and result of the melody. And then we kind of like develop. It's like a repetition of, like, if we say this is A, then it's a repetition of the A in song form, but this is not song form, this is scoring. But here we've got a more developed version of what we presented initially. And now we're going to present a slightly different B section of the melody. It's something else, because now we're going to open for a different type of conversation, which is going to be introduced by a question coming in right here. But context here.
Control freak. Listen, he's working you. And you're starting to believe his lies again.
No, I am not.
We all do it. We fall in love, we think they're perfect, but because the love makes us stupid, we don't see who they really are. You're lucky. You know why?
Why?
Because the night he tried...
So you're lucky, you know why? Why? And boom, now the why opens for a new story to be told. And with that new story to be told, musically we also go somewhere else. So that's the third part of the, structurally, the third part of the scene.
But because the love makes us stupid, we don't see who they really are. You're lucky. You know why?
Why?
Because the night he tried to kill you? Whew. He showed you his true colors, that's for damn sure. He's gonna contact you again. He's gonna try to convince you that he's not a threat. But no matter what he says, no matter what you feel inside, do not look at me. Do not engage him. That restraining order pertains to you as well. You hear what I'm saying?
I hear you.
Okay, well, I need to eat and shower and get on the road. I've got meetings back to back for the next three.
Yeah, I need to, you know, dress and shower and blah, 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 the whole thing. That's an excuse to transition to the next scene. And it's not an excuse in the story. It's meaning in terms of like a script technique. It's like we need to transition to move on. But this is the end, right? And if I bring back the video, I'll play back what I did. And now you can see how at that moment, I did not know the exact structure of the scene. But I guess subconsciously, I was understanding as I was scoring what was going on. Now that you know the structure, see how I kind of like in the video I react to this, and see how my reaction comes like 5 seconds later, but still I'm like, oh, question, this is gonna open a new block. Okay, fantastic, great. And hey, this is what I'm showing you is the highlight of a spotting session, right? Sometimes I do things like this and I mess up big time, but in this case it was successful. And again, my hypothesis, like I was reading a structure very well. So let's take a look at this one more time. 1957.
We can also have here the let's see.
By the way, what I just did is when there are some libraries, some sample libraries that sound fantastic, but are a little bit harder to use and they need a little bit more tweaking. In my case, for me, in a template like this, is my main to go strings or violins library would be Cinematic Studio Strings, which I love and it's great and I use it 90% of the times. But it is hard, it's a little bit harder to use live because it comes with all that latency, no problem. But when, and I still use it because of the, because I like it. But in this case, I needed a library that's so user-friendly and easy to use because I'm going to be performing live. That's what I, and I was gonna do like, not all libraries are good at the type of thing. So that's why I, you know, get to know your template, get to know your libraries. I chose something that I, for the type of music that I was going to write and to write it live and make it sound decent out, you know, out of the box kind of thing. And that's why I chose this one, is the Abbey Road Orchestra Violins one. So I'm like, okay, cool, I've got the motif. I think I'm going to go in this direction.
Kind of thing. You don't believe him, do you? No, of course not.
Yeah, but
I have to admit, he is, I don't know, convincing. That's because he's a lying manipulator and a wife beater. You know, he's always been this way. Actually, he only freaked out on me that one time. I mean, it was totally out of nowhere. Out of nowhere? He's been that way since the very beginning. I mean, we all saw how messed up he was. We? Who's we? Me, Rochelle, Shamika. I mean, look, we tried to tell you, but you were so in love that you wouldn't listen. I mean, don't you remember how he would just flip out over the smallest thing? That was just him being picky. That was him being a nightmare control freak. Listen, he's working you, and you're starting to believe his lies again. No, I am not. We all do it. We fall in love, we think they're perfect, but because the love makes us stupid, we don't see who they really are. You're lucky. You know why? Why? Because the night he tried to kill you, he showed you his true colors, that's for damn sure. He's gonna contact you again. He's gonna try to convince you that he's not a threat. But no matter what he says, no matter what you feel inside, do not look at me. Do not engage him. That restraining order pertains to you as well. You hear what I'm saying? I hear you. Okay, well, I need to eat and shower and get on the road. I've got meetings back to back for the next 3 weeks. Oh, and we need your pages.
Yeah, that's the vibe. That's great, Mark. You know, it's so great. Just that little touch. It says that she's
We can hear you.
Gracias, thank you. Facundo, ¿qué pasa? ¿Qué te decía? He reconocido tu voz sin mirarte. Good to see you. If you can see the director, I was saying, if you can see the director smiling slightly, that's a good sign. That's it. You'll see. I'm gonna go ahead and show you the like fleshed out version of this. You'll see it's not, you obviously it'll sound a little bit more polished, but the essence or the 80% is already done. I think this is the final. Let's see what I did. And by the way, I covered a little bit the image because this movie has finished and it has delivered, but it still has not been released, so that's why. But here we go.
Do you? No, of course not, but I have to admit he is, I don't know, convincing. That's because he's a lying manipulator and a wife beater. You know, he's always been this way. Actually, he only freaked out on me that one time. I mean, it was totally out of nowhere. Out of nowhere? He's been that way since the very beginning. I mean, we all saw how messed up he was. We? Who's we? Me, Rochelle, Shamika. I mean, look, we tried to tell you, but you were so in love that you wouldn't listen. I mean, don't you remember how he would just flip out over the smallest thing? That was just him being picky. That was him being a nightmare control freak. Listen, he's working you, and you're starting to believe his lies again. No, I am not. We all do it. We fall in love, we think they're perfect, but because the love makes us stupid, we don't see who they really are. You're lucky. You know why? Why? Because the night he tried to kill you, he showed you his true colors, that's for damn sure. He's gonna contact you again. He's gonna try to convince you that he's not a threat. But no matter what he says, no matter what you feel inside, do not look at me. Do not engage him. That restraining order pertains to you as well. You hear what I'm saying? I hear you. Okay, well, I need to eat and shower and get on the road. I've got meetings back to back for the next 3 weeks.
Otra vez no te escuchamos, Mark.
Gracias. Sorry. Thank Jerko. Yep. So that's it. Structure first. And it's very, very important. I could show you a few more scenes of this movie. In fact, I may load another one and basically like super, super clear structure. But how important the structure is, it makes a big difference. But before I would have to close this project and open another one. Just takes a minute or so. But do you have any comment, any question regarding this one or regarding what we have discussed? Let me know. Instrument use, libraries, or anything, or a little bit more about the in the kind of like the writing or composing side of things. This was live, but if I, you know, when I score behind the scenes, I set the markers first, and that gives me, and I can show you that in the other scene how I would do this if I had more time. We're good with this one? Okay, fantastic. So then I'm going to close this one. And I'm going to show file, close this one, don't save. And then I'm gonna go ahead here and let's see. Close, 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 close. Boom, open a new one. This summer house, cues.
Hello, Mark.
Hey, what up?
Hey, quick question. When you talk about the storyline and the little details about the movie, do you have to figure out yourself, or the director will tell you about those little details or the conversations or everything?
That's a great question, Param. Thanks for asking. So in the, it's a, I would say half-half. That's why we have this spotting session. This is where all these things get discussed. But also, it is they assume that you're gonna catch all these little details. But yes, sometimes like that's why we do the spotting session. And I many times have questions like this, like do we want to make this look like the villain? Oh no, not yet. Like later on in the movie. Okay, fantastic, great. And so things like this, right? When she says this, do we want to hint this or that? So no, let's keep it quiet there yet, right? Things like these are as well what you would discuss with the director. And you would come with all these things prepared in the spotting session because you've watched the movie ahead of time. And if you had doubts, you would ask them there. But yeah, that's creative with one creative, the director with another creative or artist. It's two artists or three or four people that are involved in the movie. Having a discussion, a conversation to try and plan ahead for the work that's going to be done musically. So yes, part of those conversations, these details get discussed during the spotting session.
All right, thank you.
Yeah, great question. No, they are fun. They are long, but they're fun. Okay, so I guess it's going to be, have I closed here? Yes, okay, cool. So let's, so file, open, because this is Cubase 13 now, so we're gonna go here, summer house, I think it's four, Qs, four in this case, and we're gonna go for this one. You need a break, I'm sure it's this one, you need a break, yes, open. So, loading up. And I'm gonna get rid of this video here, because it...
Mark, there are a few questions in the chat.
Oh, thank you, Esteban, thank you. Thank you guys. Sorry, haven't read. Okay. Let me see. So we're starting here. Greetings. Boom, 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 boom. Here. Okay, what scale did I use? I don't remember exactly. But basically, it's an emphasis. It's a great question, but it's making an emphasis on the intervals that I used. That's the most important part. The intervals that I use in the motif. So we've got minor thirds, we've got tritones, we've got semitones, right? The motif. Let me see if I can get the motif. Give you just 1 sec. It's this guy here, or the motif for the theme. So click up. Give me just 1 sec. Looking at another screen. Gonna make this smaller. By the way, we're streaming, right? Yes, great, awesome. Feliz Navidad. Hello, Ryan. Great, awesome. And looking here, here's the movie. And here's the summer house. Summer house. Close summer house. So this is the motif. There you go. So it's just taking from these intervals and build and kind of like expanding it to something that's way slower. It's underscore under below dialogue and behind dialogue. And just expanding this idea, basically. Hope this answers your question. So yes, well, music libraries were used. I think in the next thing that I'm opening, we will see. So we can go there. Is it opening already? Oh, there. Okay, and close. There you go. So the main one, the library that did the melody. No, it was, let's just go here. Let's make this smaller. Boom, boom. There you go. Where's the video? Video, boom. There you go. Well, that's okay. The library that did the melody was this guy here. So you know how the libraries, we've got the legato patches, right? And the legato basically is one note, the next one, and then the engine will trigger the legato transition between, let's say, E, a C, and E flat. And the reason why it sounds natural is because they trigger the transition sound between these notes. And so let's just imagine that then you would go back to C. Okay, so we had the first note and then the second note, and then we had a transition between the two notes, and then we've got this note, right? And this note in transition. And then if we go back and forth and back and forth and back and forth, what's going to happen is that the transition sound is going to start repeating, right? Because that recording was recorded once. If we hear the same recording again and again and again, every time that we transition between these two notes, it's gonna happen the same thing that happens with staccato notes. That if we don't have round robin, like for recording of the same staccato notes, then we're gonna hear the kind of machine gun effect in staccatos, right? It's very apparent and it's very obvious. The same thing happens with the transition, right? If we don't have round robin transitions, then it's going to sound repetitive and robotic, and we want to avoid that. And so good libraries have round robin transitions. That's what makes them sound natural when you do doi oi oi, which is so easy for like a live instrument or orchestra, right? But with samples, try it with your library. If it's not like some libraries just don't sound good when you do this. And again, it's not, it has a ton of reverb for, because the next unit needed a ton of reverb. It is not perfect, not nearly what an orchestra would do. But this is one of the most natural ones. That's why I chose this one when I was doing. So the main thing was this guy, and then the other thing for the kind of like the texture and things like this was the violin and cello solo. Tremolo. So I like to have the cello solo, tremolo, and sometimes tremolo sul ponte cello, but in this case just tremolo concertino in the high register, and it just like adds a little bit of an eerie texture over the other side. If we have the violins on the left side, right, we have a solo cello, tremolo, high register sul ponte cello, it will add that eerie texture over the other side on the right side in this case, and a few more things, but that is the main thing. I also used recently I've been using this guy here, the ultra this library that I'm using quite a bit, the soft strings textures from Piano Book. And it comes with different patches. It has this one which I use sometimes. It's soft, super easy to use, but in this particular cue I was using the ultra low strings, this one here, for like low, not here. Type of thing. And they also have this wobbling strings. So it's they come with regular strings, solo strings, and things like this, but also have some processed strings that come in handy sometimes. So this is kind of like processed wobbly. So sometimes you would layer this on top of other strings, and it adds that a little bit more, so if needed, kind of contemporary layer to it. But now going to this other scene, if we go here to this scene, let's take a look at this scene. Now let's just, let me see, is this the scene that we are talking about? Yes, exactly. So let's take a look at this scene. Let's see, dialogue not muted, dialogue here. And you'll see clearer structure. Again, it has three parts and in the coda, let's say. So this is earlier in the movie and it goes like this, but understand that if we got this wrong, like this is super obvious, it has three parts and the music has to change, right? If we got this wrong, we would get everything wrong. I did not know that many markers here, but let's just take a listen to this, and just for the sake of reinforcing the importance of following a structure first, or understanding a structure first and then scoring.
Dark fortress of solitude and get some sunshine in your life. Hey, why don't you go?
Let's go back in
your second. Agent, I think you need a talent. And I also know how to handle talent. And as your agent, I think you need a break.
A break?
I mean, why don't you get out of this dark fortress of solitude and get some sunshine in your life? Hey, why don't you go and stay at our summer house for a little while?
I could.
Why not? I mean, Brad and I aren't using it. I mean, he's off in Europe for some boring business conference anyway.
But look, it's the perfect place to break through a case of writer's block and get this masterpiece finished.
I don't know.
Aw, come on. I'll think about it.
Great. I'll set everything up and you can be there in 2 hours.
I said I'd think about it.
And that's it. So again, three part, generally, not always, but the three part structure generally is that, or the three act, you know, both at the macro level, at the micro level, so macro level, the entire movie, and at the micro level, so within each scene, generally follows. We've got an intro, we've got the thick of it, then we've got the kind of the conclusion. In this case, we had the conversation. This is again a weird spot where the music comes in, was a suggestion of the director. I think it worked fantastic. And then we had the transition music that needs to be here. And then we have the, you know, she after what happened, she freaks out about, you know, every place she's in, she's checking. This is a thriller suspense type of movie that sometimes what happens in this type of movies, or what I found is that the director comes and says, you know, we shot this movie, we cut this movie, and they still, the clients are saying this still doesn't look as thriller as it should look, so help with music. And so the music is sometimes a little bit more, right, it's more exaggerated, it's bigger than it should, but it's because it's what they, it's needed. You also have to understand why, you know, who's this movie for, right? And so you're asked to do these things, and so the music in this case is darker than it would appear if you look to this scene without the entire context, right? But still, anyway, three parts. It's kind of like the kind of concluding the last scene part, then the transition music, and then we've got this she arrives to the place music, and then the kind of like the coda, which is when the kind of like the bad guy is here we'll be looking at her and creating a little bit of tension as she comes in the house with this part here. And yeah, someone else was doing this. I did this movie with another composer, Nathan Bloom. He's the composer for the TV show The Flash and Arrow. He also teaches in Momentum, and we were doing this movie together. And he did the next one before I did this one, so he told me to finish in this key. So the cues matched. And I did my best, but still the cues didn't match, and he had to do an edit. So that's I didn't do good enough on my end. But anyway, yeah. So structure. Any questions? We would have a few minutes left. If you want, I can stay for a little bit longer. Let me know. Let me check out the chat. Let me see, it's good. Like the first part of the scene where there's a lot of space between the notes and not continuing music. I get this. So there was something. I'm gonna answer this way. I learned this from Jack Smalley. It's a composer that I, sadly he's gone. But he's a great composer and the great orchestrator, and I met him. Back in 2008, I took some online classes with him, and then I met him again as a student again back in 2010. I got on a scholarship and I got admitted to USC to do the screen scoring master, and he was teaching there. Back then he was in his late 80s or 90s, 90 year old. And he said, like, he taught me, sorry, He explained us so many things, and I learned so much from him. But one thing I learned, it'll come back. One thing that he said was, just the violins one section or violins section playing a slow melody. This could score an entire scene. This is sometimes is enough, and it's so beautiful. And let's just think about it for a second. Because we're using samples, that's the problem. We are using samples, and samples don't sound like the real orchestra. But let's just think about this just for a second. Just imagine if you have had an opportunity to be in a concert hall or in a scoring stage, and when it's just, you know, 16 or 30 people performing a slow melody, the violins section. There's like, it's just beauty on that. It's just, there's no need for more. The problem is that samples are not a true representation of what an orchestra is, let's say. And it's just the nature of it. It's a simplification. There's, you know, there are three dynamic layers, five dynamic layers versus, you know, millions of real dynamic layers in a real strings orchestra or whatever, right? So it's a simplification of the product, and it sounds more synthetic because it's a simplification, and we do things to make it sound more alive, organic, etc. when needed. But the real orchestra is different, right? It's pure vibrance, it's pure human imperfection in real life, but the good type of imperfection that makes the music sound beautiful. And so just in slow melody, it has so much power. And that's kind of what we are trying to recreate here. The second element that makes us not go with something simple like a slow melody behind dialogue, it's our own insecurities. Like, well, this is not going to be enough, right? And then we start adding more stuff to make it sometimes less is more, right? And if you want the proof of that, just, you know, Michael Giacchino, right? Just listen to Michael Giacchino. And one of the most notorious examples of that was when he was scoring Lost TV show, and the super famous now kind of like ARP notes, like there would be a dialogue or something going on, and it's just this low ARP note, doing, and then waiting like 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 12 seconds, doing, right? And it was so effective. It's like it worked so well. It was something like, and he would let it ring. And they were having that dialogue, that tense dialogue. And then in between lines. And then it's like, there you go, 2 minutes of music. and so just sometimes something like this is very, very effective. Okay. What was the percussion? Minimalism is very, very effective. Very effective, I agree. Yes. The percussion here, I guess you're asking this guy. Yeah, let's take a look. I forgot, but let's take a look at what we've got here. So let's make effective and more dynamics. Yep. Okay, so let's mute the dialogue here. So we had 3 weeks to do this. So we cheated a little bit, right? Not cheated, but it's perfectly fine. But it's hybrid elements, pulses, and things like this that allow you to score a little bit faster. But let's analyze this section here. So we're gonna make these just short tracks in between the locators, and let's see what we've got here. So you've got this guy. No, this is Cinematic Studio Strings. I know that you asked about the percussion, but let's go one by one. And then we've got the staccato strings doing these guys. No, here, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Oops, sorry. And this is all Cinematic Studio Strings with some pizzicatos and spiccatos. Spiccatos in the what? The violins too. So all together the strings do this. Okay, and then on top of that, we're gonna have, so I'm gonna go with all the melodic instruments and then all the, so I'm gonna skip the shaker for now. And then on top of that, we've got the harp as well. It's got, it seems like the harp is going press de la table. So it's this technique here. Yes, T. So press de la table. So we can, so if this, what is it doing exactly? So yeah, so Nathan made me compose in C sharp. I was like, thank you. So if the, so the harp, this is press de la table as opposed to like natural. That's natural harp. Press de la table is like closer to the wood. So it sounds, instead of, it'll sound more like this is the key switch. Natural. Sounds a little bit more. More metallic, and has a little bit more of attack and bite. And I like it for, I liked it, I guess, for this part here.
We can hear you, Mark.
The microphone.
Oh, gracias, thank you. Ah, so anyway, so this would work. You're fast. This would work, this thing here, right? Meaning just the strings and the harp, etc. But we needed a little bit more energetic moving forward element, those type of elements that make the music move forward with a little bit more intensity, because it's a transition scene. And so here's where we added a few more things. There are a couple more orchestral elements, like this guy here, the woods, doing nothing. So just color. And other than that, everything else is the percussion that you were asking about. So what do we have? Oh, and the piano, by the way. Piano is also doing the part of the... Yep. So that is what, that's kind of like the emotional component, what sets the tone, the mood, and then we've got everything else that is going to be percussion. So first we're going to have the shaker here, so no, this guy here. So first element, then we're gonna have what else? A little bit of, what else? Hybrid, the sub kick, this guy here, move things along. This is from what, old library, haven't updated, Artifact Fractal. So I think it's an old library from Audio Imperia. Then I've got a little bit of Armageddon. I think it's this guy here. Yeah, the rims, very subtle here on the other side. We're gonna take a listen to this, just these guys. So, as I knew. Oops. And then just pulses, these guys here. We open the pulses, just pulses here. This is from the old library, Audio Imperia Legacy. This guy here. This. So these pulses come from this one. Just so you know. And yeah. all together. Sounds like this. Here's a little bit that I forgot to mention about the soft strings. See? It goes with the violin's one legato, which is the one that sounds realistic, but see? Real violins, and then on top of that, the soft strings that kind of adds that hybrid tone to it. Just the strings with the hybrid stuff on the other side. Yeah, it just adds a little bit of texture and color. So that's that. So basically, it's just a string, some staccatos, pizzicatos, and things like this. A piano on top, some melodic long notes for the to add an arc on top of the pulsed orchestra, and or short notes, and then on top of that, just some pulses, shaker, and some small, you know, top of the mix percussion, like the again shakers, rims, etc. The arp doing arpeggios, like a diggy, and that's it. All right. Yeah, exactly. The pulse is, it was really moving everything along. Exactly. That's the whole intent of the pulse. All right. Yes.
It's Ian here. I was just left a question in the chat. I was just admiring the minimalist melodies, and I just wanted to know if you had any advice to kind of keep my instinct of overwriting melodies when you're doing that kind of background pulse, because I kind of think, oh, I've done this for, I don't know, 10 seconds. Now I feel I've got to write something more.
That's such a great question. And my answer to this is you're gonna have to force yourself to do this. I struggle so much. In fact, I am working on an album right now that is called Less. And the reason why I'm working on this album is to literally, well, just because I just want to have fun and I want to do something that's not scoring at the moment. But most importantly, I want to force myself to keep it as simple as possible. And it's just going to be, again, not a scoring, kind of like song form type of writing. But I'm trying to keep it as simple as possible. So when it comes to this, you know, how to not overwrite things in a scoring context is what you mean?
Well, in a scoring context, but just generally, I think it would be a useful thing to practice.
Okay, let me give you the answer, like the most tangible answer that I can give you. So ultimately, it is very, very different when we are composing in front of the sequencer, that which is, you know, active writing, than passive listening. When we are writing, we are involved, we justify every action that we take or every decision that we make based on the active work of composing music, and which is very different than actually listening as the audience to your music. So, but it's very hard to listen as you're composing, to listen back to your music as if you weren't the composer. It's really, really hard. So, mm-hmm. What I like to, and sometimes, and because when in the active process of composing, everything is justifiable, sometimes we make things a little bit more complex than they should be. So one thing that works for me is to, and sometimes you don't have time to do this, but it is a skill that you would train. But for something as pure as this, which is, you know, standalone music, and I want to keep it as simple as possible, and I'm working on this one at the moment, is to play back to your music as you are doing something else. Because good music, like if, for example, in this case, the album is going to be called Less. And it's supposed to me, what I'm envisioning with this music is like, my kids are 4 and 5. And when they come back from daycare, like at 2 or 3 p.m., which is that usually we do, arts and crafts, like whatever, right? Yeah. So now it's Christmas, so we do, you know, Christmas stuff. Yeah. And it's fun. And we put some soft music in the background. And I was like, okay, it should be music that I could put in the background and it's not too destructive, would not distract us, right?
Yeah.
Which is good background music, melodic, beautiful, nice background kind of thing. And so also it should be music that as I'm working, right, I could play it back, I could put it in loop and it would not distract me. So in a way, I'm forcing myself to be in the kind of listener, right, or audience to this music. And then I play the music and at some point it's like, oh, wow, this melody is way too loud, which is a form of complexity, or, oh, this melody is too developed, right? And it's like, let me simplify it, or this element is too complex, right? So this helps, there's one thing. The other thing is just it's just practicing and forcing yourself to write less and then listen to it tomorrow, which is the same thing, right? And you'll see that most of the times that was enough. Now I'll share an experience with you that I've shared with the group sometimes. Hopefully this is not repetitive, but hopefully this adds some value. So I was working on a movie with the director. His name was David, and that was in a Spanish movie. The Pixel Theory, so produced in Spain, and I did this. I was scoring, and there was this one scene. Director told me this is the most important scene. You have to nail it. The music needs to be perfect. And it was very musically was very simple. Strings and piano, right? The strings providing the support, the piano providing the melody and the melodic content. So I compose the music, I do the piano, I try to keep it as simple as possible, just the few little touches that the piano needed to do. And I'm like, this is good, I'm happy. I hit export and I send the music. I did not listen back to the music. I send the music to the director. And then next morning, I'm like, let's see if I've got notes from director. I've got an email praising the music. It's like, this is amazing, this is great, this is exactly what the scene needed. And I was like, ah. Got it. That was fantastic. Yes, I knew it. And now my ego is like, well, let me just go listen to the music that I send them. I open the email. I load the track. I hit play. And to my surprise, I just exported the strings, not the piano, right? And I'm like, oh no, my gosh, the piano. And I was so proud of what the piano was doing. But basically, I sent the soft background supporting strings to the director, and they loved it. So that was a simpler version of what I intended, and he loved it. Now, at that point, I had two options. Either I follow my ego, and I'm like, but I still can do a better version, kind of telling him, and I had the second version with the piano, or just leave it the way it was, right? And so sometimes less is more. It's just forcing ourselves to do it this way, listening to composers that accomplish the goal, keeping it very, very simple. And not always we're going to need the music to be simple, but many times we will. So that is what I would tell you. For example, in this case, the motif or the main thing in this song is this guy, right? Let me make sure that you could hear this. So this guy. And then we've got the accompaniment. We may be recording this with a live orchestra. And so, you know what? I've got the answer for you. In the back of my mind is like, I'm going to be recording with an orchestra. I'm going to write some music. So when the musicians perform this, they think this is good music, which is completely destructive, right? It's completely destructive to the process. The goal is this should be music that is simple, that is background music, it's beautiful, nice melodies, etc. Maybe a little bit memorable, but it just stays there in the background. End of the story. That's where you should focus. And so as I'm doing the kind of the accompaniment parts of this melody, right, the strings come in and do something like this. Thank you. right? There are so many things that the strings could do, and I decided to go with E flat, F E, end of the story, and then the rest of the string is just tremolo, kind of like chamber orchestra. That's it. There's no much more, and then it repeats the same thing with a variation. Now the violins are going, violins one, violins two, are going to do the same thing, and then it's going to go up a third. So, could it be simpler, right? And just discovering and appreciating that there is so much more to the music than the note that you write, right? If this gets recorded and then it gets mixed, it's the mastery of the musicians themselves, right? It's the art of the mixing later on, someone who has experience. It's the art of deciding this goes half a dB up in balance and this goes half a dB down or 2 dBs down and everything is perfectly balanced. The performance of this very simplistic melody has been perfectly done. There's so much more to the music, and it's just taking less ego in the process of creation and letting the music, and understanding that there are different steps to talk about the three egos, right? When we make music more complex, it's because we are listening to one of these three egos, the first or the second one. And so generally, you're going to have kind of like, let me see if I can find this slide somewhere. Drive, three egos, found it, I think, the three egos. No, I did not find it. Going to three egos, three day momentum, or 3 day. Let's see. Maybe here. Give me just one sec. Deliverables. No, I can find it. But basically, if we look at the process of music creation this way, sometimes we've got the kind of like the internal ego and the external ego as the two main egos, and then we've got kind of like a bigger ego. But the internal ego, it sounds something like, I'm gonna write music that is the best piece of music that I've ever created, right? And why this is good, because it pushes the boundaries for you to try to create something better. Sometimes it's going to make the music more complex than it needs to be.
I put it in the chat, Mark.
Oh, thank you. Gracias, Esteban. Thank you. Thank you so much. This helps. There you go. And I'm going to put it here. Now I'm going to share the screen. And we have, three egos guide. Fantastic. Thanks, Esteban. Saved the day. And we're going to open it here. So internal ego, it's about you, right? And again, trying to create things that make you proud. It's gonna be a constructive force that causes you to grow and learn new things, to push the boundaries. But if this is the only force that's governing your decisions, it usually leads to, it has to be a masterpiece syndrome, which leads to making it more complex, right? The second ego is it's about them kind of thing, the external ego. And kind of like, this is where like, I'm going to prove everyone how awesome I am, right? I'm going to publish this, and because I'm going to publish, people are going to listen, and I want them to see that I'm such a great composer, right? This, again, it's going to make things, this comes out of insecurity, and it says, want them to know how great a composer I am. Internal and external ego focus on the who and the what kind of thing, instead of the why, which is the third ego. It's like I don't have a better name for this one, but it's the it's the one, bigger ego, whatever. But it's the one that focuses on the why. Why are we doing what we are doing? Like, why am I composing this music? And it's focusing on that outcome. And so, for example, we are scoring a movie. We focus on the why. Okay, why am I scoring? So why am I doing this music? Well, I'm scoring this movie. Okay, fantastic. So what is the outcome? The outcome is to elevate this story. Okay, fantastic, great. In this particular scene, what are we trying to do? Why are we writing this music? Well, it needs a little bit more intensity, aggression, add a little bit of layer of suspense and thriller that the cat is not able to do. Great, fantastic. Then we're gonna write the music that's needed. Oh, the music needs to speed up the scene because it's just a little bit slow. Well, we're gonna need some pulses and some things. There are things that speed up a scene. There are things that will slow down. Drones will slow down the scene. No, we need for the audience to understand that this is an important moment and we need to tell the story. Okay, it's time for the melody to come in, right? So it's understanding, obviously there's a scoring technique at this point, but it's understanding what needs to be done and then focusing on the why. That will humble us and will allow us to write something that's simpler.
Right.
So that's where I would, and then it's a technique that will allow us to actually keep it simple and make it still work. Does this answer your question?
It does.
Awesome. It's a fantastic question. There's an entire class that we could do around this. It's such an interesting conversation. I love it. That's a great, great, great question. Thanks. That's cool. All right. Anyone else? Any other question? Thanks, Esteban.
You're welcome. Acheron or Archeron, he posed two times in the question and you
okay. This one? Sorry, yeah. If the score is longer, does it also work with a three-part structure? If the scene is longer, does it also work with a three-part structure? Or is there any other structure that are more suitable? Because sometimes I hear people say that the music itself is more important than the follow the image. Thanks. Yes, exactly. So when you hear people say that that music itself is more important than following the image, usually, in my opinion, I think they are talking about not like the for the music not to be Mickey Mousing all the time and to sing the music to every cut or hitting every beat type of thing of the scene. Still the scene, no matter how short or long it is, it'll have a structure, right? Sometimes when you have like 7 minutes of music, that generally is a concatenation of scenes. Each one of the scenes will have its own internal structure, and each scene generally is going to be different. Sometimes, though, towards the end of the movie, there's this super long scene that's going to be minutes and minutes of music. Maybe we're talking between 3, 6, 7, 8, 10 minutes of music, which is kind of like where everything comes together, and it's this one big arc. So still, structure applies. I think if you listen to great music, great composers, generally they are able to compose music that it's more like an arc, right? If we look at the an example that comes to mind, kids animation movie, classic at this point, but I guess Test Drive, How to Train Your Dragon. Let me see if I can find the actual scene, not the music. But this is a song. It's a song, but that's what it is. But it works so well with the picture. Why? Again, structure. And it's not following. It's not Mickey Mousing everything, even though there's a little bit of Mickey Mousing. But that's a cool thing. But there's a clear arc. This is just, it's a, if you can do song structure, you don't always have to. You don't, in fact, most of the times, song structure is not going to work. But you can see if sometimes if like, and there are composers that will do this masterfully, Alexandre Desplat, etc., right? And you are follow the music is an arc that follows the structure of the scene. Let's see if we can see How to Train Your Dragon. Just I think, yeah, this one.
Mahito.
There you go.
Okay there, bud. We're gonna take this nice and slow. Here we go. Oh, here we go. Position.
What is this? This is the intro, right? So this is song structure. This is what the intro.
3, no, 4.
By the way, if you count the bars of this, it's just so symmetrical. It's so good. It's to perfection. But there we go. So, I mean, sorry for destroying this with my commentaries, but what is the music doing in the intro? It is doing the exact same thing that the scene or is doing. It's preparing, right? So intro is preparing, and now boom, we present the theme. Is where they actually start flying, right? So it just it works perfectly. And then when the horns melody come in, it's so I don't destroy it more. I'm gonna talk ahead of time, but when the horns melody come in, like the big theme, that by the way is the first time that we hear to completion the horns melody that we're gonna hear in a second. That theme has been presented in this, you know, bits and pieces before this scene at the beginning of the movie, and now we hear complete for the first time, which makes complete sense again structurally, because the first time that they are flying together, and that these bits and pieces of the melody literally have been presented during the movie as he was building the apparatus so they can fly together. It's just so good. It's so good. Anyway, but let's continue. So the first melody is introduced for the first time, and then the horns melody as they go down and start flying, which is when you get goosebumps, and there's a reason for that. And obviously it's beautiful music, it's great music, but also there is I think something that's even more powerful, which is the structure that has, you know, that it's how the music has been presented and how we arrive to this moment. This is not Mickey Mousing, but it, and I'm sure this is out of chance, but it works so well, right? But it's not like he's not trying to Mickey Mouse. It just structurally it works.
Yes, it worked.
Now here's more clear Mickey Mousing coming up.
Sorry.
This thing doesn't need, it just happened to be.
Yeah, I'm on it. Position 4, 3. Yeah! Go, baby! Yeah! Oh, this is amazing! The wind in my cheat sheet!
So we had the A, the B. This would is in a song structure, this would work as the bridge, right? For the main theme to come back. But the music is doing exactly what you are saying. The music is not following the scene every, you know, cut by cut or Mickey Mousing the music. Again, it's an arc and it's doing its thing, but it just works perfectly. Yeah, like this is the moment. So the melody comes back, obviously. But what does this mean? He's like, oh my gosh, insecurities, right? He's basically the story that's being told musically here is that Hiccup gets rid of his insecurities out of, like, he's forced to because of the situation, and he's like, fuck it, right? Throws the thing away, and he's like, I'm gonna what? Trust my intuition, and now two become one. It's a fucking metaphor of life, right? And the two become one at this point, which this obviously, if you follow the melodic development of this entire saga with the three movies, this is so well resolved in the third movie when they, I'm not gonna spoil it, but I'm sure that you've seen the movie, so you know how it ends. And the music ends the same way. But here, right, now comes the theme once again, where and then just trust the intuition, Rhea, trust the intuition, which is the hardest thing to do in life because the system protects itself, right? And you go back to your comfort zone. But he was like, he crosses the threshold and goes beyond, and this is what kind of like starts the hero's journey on a deeper level, right? That's the first battle that he wins. And so here's where the music comes back. He trusts his intuition and he kind of like gains a new power. Just like what I'm talking about, this hero's journey, you know, structure or script structure, and this is exactly what's going to happen right now. It just happens so masterfully. The story is very well told, obviously, in a very simple way for kids, but also the music or the composer understood, obviously, he understood John Powell and did a great job. And but that's what it's not, he works very well, not just because, oh, it works with the picture. No. It works with the story at the three levels. And I'm not talking about the structure, the three parts, at the three levels, right? Here's the main story, right away, right? Like what's happening, what you can see, here's what's happening. Here's the character growth, right? Which is what, and then the third layer, which is the moral of the story, right? What you, the viewer, get, right? This is a message for you. That's why we like movies, because movies are a representation of our own hero's journeys and our growth in life, right? And it is telling you there's a moment in life where you may need to transcend and go to the next level. And for this, you'll have to forget 80% of what you know and trust the 20% that's going to get you to the next level. And for that, you're going to have to trust your intuition. And the music, it's like, if you don't get the message that's being, you know, shared here, here you go. Hopefully you get it, right? And the music is doing this perfectly. Obviously, the joke at the, it's so good. It's so good. I mean, like, go, just listen to this music, stand alone, count the bars. And on top of that, it's perfectly symmetric. It's just so good. Anyway, I am not a John Powell fan. But this cue is great. This is a really good cue. I like it. I explained it several times because it's good. It's just it's a good worth studying. So there you go. That's what, in my opinion, means not following the scene too closely. It follows the structure of the scene, which is way more powerful, in my opinion. Does this answer your question? Hopefully it does. Yes,
thank you.
Yeah, all right. It was a great question. It opened a great conversation Okay, any other comment, question that you have? Otherwise, 5 minutes max, we're going to close the class. You good?
Yes. Have good. Sometimes, because depends the project also. Because sometimes, for example, the video games, right, also have cinematics. Like, for example, this movie, now we see, happened a lot of things in very short time.
Yes.
And it's animation. What means this? The first things know the person see the movie is he know that is not real. Okay? The movie need accompany more. I think it need have more character for it's more believable the movie. In one moment, the movie is the top. O sea, it's up of the foley and the ambience. That is don't happen so much in the normally cases of movie we get. Because the movie is normally about real people, we need to compose music. It's more simple, more minimal. So it's I think it's that is one of the points we need consider also in the movie, the price, right? How it's believable for the persons when see the movie Nick is a coherence, right? Nick have sense. The level of how much instruments, how much minimal, right?
Absolutely. Yeah, it has to have coherence with the movie. Exactly. And animation definitely. Yes, animation. It's very different than real action. Definitely. Yeah, agree 100%. Good point. Cool. Anything else that any one of you wanted to add? Questions, comments? We're good? Okay. So if that is the case, I would say Merry Christmas, everyone. Have a good one. Enjoy the holiday season. Have a great one. Thanks so much for attending. I don't take this for granted. I appreciate you being with me for these couple of hours. Means a lot. I don't take your time for granted. I know it's one of your biggest assets. I hope that you got some value out of this. Enjoy the week. Enjoy the holiday season. And I'll see you next week or in a couple of weeks. All right? We'll be sending an a notification. All right. Have a great one. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Merry Christmas, Tori.
Merry Christmas. Feliz Navidad. See ya. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.